Welcome friends. This video is about energy saving in furnace. Furnaces are used for home heating as well as it is also used in industry. Industry has got a huge application of furnaces for material heating and melting. Either thermally driven or electrically driven furnace is used in industry for either of the process. So this course talks about why energy efficiency is important whenever we are operating a furnace. This course is useful to all the engineers who are associated in the field of boiler or furnace and to the energy consultants. This course talks about different types of furnaces, their compositions and their energy efficiency analysis. Two methods of efficiency calculation is discussed in detail in this course. And coming next to that, how to save energy for both thermal and electrically driven furnaces. And lastly, there is a useful list of checklist. Sometimes we have seen that furnace efficiency is as low as 10%. Yes, just 10%. When we talk of a fuel driven furnaces. So how to improve the efficiency of this type of furnaces, that is discussed in this course at length. Prior going for that, the discussion is there about internal construction of the furnace. Furnace is made of which parts, how they operate, and their classifications. They are discussed at length. Basically, furnace can be of a batch type or it can be of a continuous loading type. So both type of furnaces, they have a different handling mechanisms. So based on handling mechanism, different types of arrangements, they are discussed and their comparisons is shown in this video. The important part of this video series is efficiency calculation. For an existing or for a new furnace, we can calculate efficiency by direct and indirect method. So both methods are discussed in detail and there is a loss calculation method shown in this video. Following next is the most important part of this is how to save energy. There is a huge amount of waste heat going out, so it can be utilized by different methods of adapting waste heat recovery. We can adapt oxygen enrichment, that is supplying oxygen to assist the combustion taking place in the furnace. Enhancing heat transfer processes by different methods, that is also discussed. Heat loss can be prevented or it can be restored by different methods by heat recovery, that is discussed. And for electrical furnaces, different way to save the energy, and for the selection of the high frequency machine as well as comparison of AC and DC furnaces is also shown. Finally, there is a checklist which is helpful to all type of furnaces. So I trust that this course will be helpful if you are looking to increase efficiency of furnaces or boiler or oven. Thank you.